Hello, my name is Donaldo, and for part one of our GAN application series, we will be going over one of the many applications that are possible when using gate drivers. This video will give a brief overview of LiDAR and will explain how you can create nanosecond pulses. We will go over an introduction to LiDAR, some LiDAR applications, a LiDAR block diagram and schematic, then end by showing how you can create nanosecond pulses. I will begin by explaining what LiDAR is. LiDAR stands for light detection and ranging. LiDAR operates by using light in the form of a pulsed laser to detect objects and map their distances, which is why it is sometimes referred to as time of flight. There is a transmission system that sends out a short, high current light pulse. This pulse will bounce off of objects and eventually return to a receiver. The time between the signal leaving and returning can then be used to calculate the distance the pulse traveled. You will be able to get more accurate results for moving objects the faster you are able to transmit signals. LiDAR can be used in automotive, robotics, drones, rangefinders, retinal imagers, surveying equipment, speed measurement devices, and much more. Many of these applications require high speeds, and the use of a good gate driver can help enable those quicker speeds. Here at TI, we generally recommend using a loci driver for your LiDAR applications. Two gate drivers that we recommend would be the LMG1020 and LMG1025-Q1, which are GAN-based gate drivers. These two gate drivers are great since they are capable of high frequency applications, nanosecond pulse widths, and have a short propagation delay. They are able to drive a FET to produce a less than 1.5 nanosecond laser optical pulse in excess of 100 watts, making them great for LiDAR applications. The picture on the screen shows a block diagram of a general LiDAR application from our reference design, CHEETAH01573, which I will link at the end for your convenience. Some of the key components are in the blue box, which include a buffer for nanosecond pulse widths, the driver, FET, and laser diode. The driver will pulse the FET on and off so that the laser diode can send out multiple pulses to map objects and their distances. This slide shows the schematic from CHEETAH01573, which shows a layout for LiDAR. The diagram shows an LDO on the top left, the driver, FET, and load. One key piece from this schematic that I want to highlight is the input buffer, which is shown by the red box. The purpose of this input buffer is to create nanosecond pulse widths. This slide will go over how the input buffer from the schematic works. In this case, N- is tied to ground to serve as an enable. Therefore, the output would be high whenever the N+ signal goes high. This method requires an RC filter, AND gate, and splitting one of your inputs together before they enter the AND gate. One input will go high, as shown by the N+ signal, but the other input will be affected by the RC filter and will instead gradually increase, as shown by the N- signal. When both inputs are higher than the threshold voltage, the N+ pin will go high, causing the output to go high. When it needs to go off, the N+ signal will provide a quicker turnoff since there is nothing to slow it down. Therefore, the output will go low when the N+ signal drops below the threshold voltage. The period in between when both signals are above the threshold voltage will dictate the time that the signal is on, which can be used to generate a 1 to 2 nanosecond pulse at the input, causing the same response at the output. An alternate way to create a 1 nanosecond pulse is by using two input signals. For this to work, one of the signals will have to be delayed. In this case, it is the N- signal. For reference, the output will follow the N+ signal when N- is low. When looking at the timing diagram, we see that N+ goes high first, which will cause the output to go high as well. Then, when the N- signal goes high, the output will go low. The delay between the two input signals going high, as shown by the red dotted lines, will be the time that the output is high. Therefore, if the delay between the two signals going high is 1 nanosecond, then the output will be high for 1 nanosecond. This could then be done repeatedly to generate multiple 1 nanosecond pulses. Here are some of the references that I used. Please feel free to visit them if you want to learn more about any of the information that I have covered in this video.